Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to the Social.in channel. This week on the Social Media Weekly, we're talking about Google's search box update. We're talking about Yoast SEO, the new version. We're talking about the Internet Marketing Trends report by Merriam-Webster. And we're talking about Facebook's deepfakes problem. Let's get started. The first bit of news that we have for you today is that Google is rolling out an update to their Google search box, which adds icons next to the section titles. So next to news, next to videos, next to images, you'll see icons going forward. You may be thinking that people who work in digital marketing get excited for nothing, but the fact remains that Google rolled out this feature in 2010 and then killed it in 2011, and now they've brought it back. This feature will impact click-through rates to those various sections and will shape design language across the internet. There is a link in the description to the complete article. The next bit of news that we need to talk about is everyone's favorite Yoast SEO plugin, which rolled out a new version, version 11.4. In this version, they moved the support for schema.org from their Glue plugin into their main plugin, and they add support for a new type of structured data, FAQ pages. So if you are a website with a lot of FAQ content, I highly recommend that you update to the latest update. There is a link in the description with a complete changelog. Every year, Merriam-Webster, the queen of the internet, who formerly was at KPCB and now is at Bond Capital, releases something called the Internet Marketing Trends Report, and this year she released it at the Code Conference 2019. The report is 333 pages long, but the parts that you need to know is that now in the world, there are 3.8 billion people with access to the internet. That's over 50% of the world's population. 12% of that internet population now lives in India, 21% in China, and 8% only in the US. You may be thinking that it's a great time to be alive, right? Wait for the next story. I will link to the Merriam-Webster report in the description. It has a video version in case you're too lazy to read the report. So that next story that I wanted to talk about, you remember the Facebook Research app? It's an enterprise class app which Apple shut down a couple of months back. The way this thing works is that Apple has a test flight program and a general app store. You and me download apps from the app store, but most other people working inside companies download apps from the test flight app store. Facebook had an app in the test flight program called Facebook Research, where they will get root access to your phone and in return pay you $20 a month. In a recent letter to Senator Richard Blumenthal's office, it came out that Facebook had compromised 1,87,000 users across the world this way, and out of them, 1,55,000 were Indians. If you're listening to this story and wondering where do I sign up for Facebook Research, we need to talk. The other Facebook story that we need to talk about is Facebook's cryptocurrency called Project Libra. We've already told you quite a lot about this cryptocurrency. It's being unveiled next week on June 18th. Now we learned, according to Wall Street Journal, that PayPal, Uber, Visa, MasterCard, Stripe, and Booking.com have signed up. They've paid $10 million to act as nodes in the governance and participate in financial benefits from Project Libra. There is a link in the description. Unfortunately, you need to be a subscriber to the Wall Street Journal to read it. Final story involves Facebook and deepfakes. So a fake video is a video which is made by human beings, so passe, but a deep fake video is a fake video made by artificial intelligence. A couple of weeks back, we told you about Nancy Pelosi's deep fake video, which was trending on Facebook. Facebook put up a disclaimer directing users to fact-checking websites so that they could decide whether the video was true or not. Now, a Mark Zuckerberg deepfake video has been posted on Instagram. It basically has Mark Zuckerberg saying that he controls billions of people, their futures, and their secrets. Facebook again has put up a notice directing people to fact-checking websites so that they can decide whether the video is true or not. All this has to do with Section 230 of the Communications Decency Act in the United States, which makes a difference between a platform and a publisher. Facebook has long held that they are a platform, not a publisher, and therefore not liable for the content on their platform. There is a link in the description to the video. It's still on Instagram. I highly suggest you take a look. That's about it for this week's episode. There is also a story about WhatsApp threatening to sue people. but I'll hold that one till we know more about the story. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Drop your comments in the comment section down below. Subscribe to the social.in channel on YouTube. Turn on notifications so that you never miss a video. And we will see you guys in the next one.